Good day, everyone. This is Engine Cadet Valentino Mark Manson. And today I will be having simulation regarding the engine room flooding. And before starting the simulation, I will be introducing to you the group 3 members. We have Valentino Mark Vincent, Joseph Ray Lagras, then Joseph Hadrake, then Japet John Peña, then Van Excel Melgazo, then Franz De Lumayo, then Joshua Lebradelia, then James Robert Lepetin, and then Lloyd Lacambra. And then let's start the simulation. So to start the simulation, let's press F1. And at this moment, let's wait for further instructions. So the instruction is all about stuck engine we have been aground. So we need to check if the engine is in stuck mode. So to ensure it, we go to the panel directory and then the auto check main engine control. So as we can see, so the engine is in stuck mode. And then let's go back to the those wheel slats tank and then let's wait for another instruction. So there is an alarm. So it says that the level in the aft bilge well is in high. So let's acknowledge the alarm and then silence. So to rectify this, so we need to open this pump by clicking auto, and then let's open this bulb. So this bulb will be the way of the water from our bilge well to our dirty bilge water tank. So, and also as we can observe, so the level in our engine, the level of the water in our engine room is increasing. So let's go to the seawater system. Let's check. So here it is. So the level is increasing. So the alarm is all about the bilge well level. So it is increasing or above normal. So let's just acknowledge this and then silence. Thank you. So since the level of the water in our engine room are increasing, so we need to empty this level or suck this level. So in order to empty this level, we need to open this emergency suction valve. And then let's open this pump going to our ballast system. So let's first open this valve, then start this pump, so that the water in our engine room will be sucked going to our ballast system. And then let's wait if this level will be becomes zero. And then let's close back this suction emergency suction valve. And also, we need to rectify the leakage, because this level will not become empty because there is a leakage. So we need to rectify the leakage first. So we'll go to the sludge tank, then go to the malfunction DSM. Then we need to reset the leakage. So the leakage will be in our hull damage since we are aground. So we need to reset this. Click reset. And then, as you can see, so the level is increasing because the leakage are decreasing because the leakage are being rectified. So let's wait until this level will become zero. And also in our Beltsville tank, so as you can see, so the level are not going down because it signifies that there is also leakage in our tanks. So we need to rectify the leakages in these tanks. So to rectify it, so let's go to the M, and then we need to reset all the leakages. So we need to reset this. So as you can see, so the level is decreasing. So it means that the leakages are being rectified. So and then let's wait until the normal level will happen. And let's proceed to the seawater system. So let's check the water level. So the level are now zero. So since there is no water in our engine room, so we need to close this emergency suction valve. Then let's close this pump. And then this valve. Then let's go back to the sludge dump. So then let's wait until this level will become normal. Thank you. So as we can observe, so the level in our belts field are in normal. So at this moment, we will be waiting until the time will end. And this also level will become also zero, so let's wait until it becomes empty. as we can see in our the level in our belt swell tank, so it is at lowest peak, and by this it is all good to end this simulation. So let's end this simulation and see the score. So F3. So here the score is 100%. So it was successful. So that's all for the engine room flooding. Thank you and God bless.